everything is so different in science than in art. You have to find the middle somehow. How to find it, I think, is the most probably complex question that was never properly answered. Successful collaborations between artists and scientists always happened on very personal level. Maybe that's kind of the core question of this class, right? How to bring science student and art student in the same room and try to jumpstart some sort of conversation.
This is going to be a very exploratory class, which have as an initial entry point use MIT Nano facilities to initiate the conversation. If their background is design, if their background is art, if their background is science, we really push the students to forget the language that they're comfortable with through exposure to different concepts.
You say these are remnants of humans within the MIT Nano. I would rephrase it to, it's the residue of interaction of human and the machine.
Coming in, it was like a very new experience for me. My project, it's inspired by like block printing, where usually you have like this block and you like develop some like shape and then you stamp it on a paper and you create art from it. And because of our partnership with MIT Nano, I wanted to explore the possibility of doing this sort of block printing or stamping process on like the nano or micro level.
In a way, like, you know, you're wearing now hat of the researcher, you know, slash artist, right? But then, you know, once you're achieving this, you know, now you need to wear hat of the curator and editor.
My project officially is called The Precipitation of Life. It looks at moss at an atomic level through a SEM microscope. The idea is to infiltrate art in spaces that it doesn't exist, in its building, in its clean rooms. Nano is so clean and so sanitary that it doesn't exist, and therefore I'm trying to infiltrate life in various ways.
My project was a model of an inflatable dome with solar cell technology that is currently in research at the MIT Nano.
I kind of got the idea of a smaller model where it's using the technology that it's capable of now, but also as a fetish object where it's able to kind of sustain itself by producing energy for itself.
Artists situate themselves as more of an observer or a documenter of what happens in the science world. That kind of created a distance between what science can be and what art can be.
Here, you'll see.
You have to have a language of science. You have to be able to comprehend art. You don't want to be somebody who is shallow with either of them.
This class is some sort of negotiation in the middle.
The students, they are like revealing things that we are not necessarily talking about, but it exists and it needs to be brought about to conversation.